Try to keep my comments brief. It's a long concert, got a lot of stuff going on. The Highlanders just got back, the Highlanders and the Bells, just got back from a long weekend, last weekend, where we toured Yankton, Madison, and Sioux Falls, performed for some great churches, had a lot of fun, bonded, made great music. So what you're hearing today is some of the music that we haven't performed for you in the past. So a couple of songs were from our sacred set. We had a set that was songs from faraway lands, and then we did kind of a fun set. So that was the first two were from our sacred set, then the Apamoy Shungwe's songs from faraway lands. The next one is, it's Bohemian Rhapsody. And this is probably one of the most challenging arrangements out there. It requires the sopranos to sing way up in the stratosphere. I think they have to sing high B flats. The altos have to sing high Gs. The tenors, I don't even know what note they have to sing, but it's up there. And as they all nod and go, yeah. So it's when you think about it, you know, the Bohemian Rhapsody, the song by Queen, is a really awesome, crazy, polyphonic spree, but this version is all a cappella, so all of the instrumental parts, all of the harmonies are all done by the voices, so it makes it just a really challenging piece, and we're very excited to sing it for you now. So here is Bohemian Rhapsody.
So you think you can stone me and spit in my
Okay, while Wesleyan Choir is getting assembled, I've got some really exciting news to share with all of you. So I know many of you are sitting out there in the audience and you're saying to yourself, boy, I wish I could be up there with those folks. They look like they're having a lot of fun. Well, guess what? Now you can. Starting next fall, we are going to bring the community together with our students to perform Handel's Messiah. We did Handel's Messiah. There we go. Yeah, I love the guests. Love it. We did Handel's Messiah back in 2015 with a community group and Wesleyan Choir. I think it's time that we do it again with Lyricwood. So be on the lookout for starting probably around July. There will be Facebook notifications. There will be posters. There will be ads in the paper. There will be bulletins in the church bulletins. But we're going to get the word out to have you, if you're interested, potentially join us to sing the Messiah. We're going to rehearse Thursday evenings, 7 to 9, over at Smith 211. And it'll be a really great experience to do that again combined. And if that kicks off, takes off, might keep doing it for a couple of years or so. But very excited to do that, and I think everyone's going to really have a great time with that. So I think the Wesleyan Choir is about to be ready. So that was my big news I want to share with you. I actually, while they're finishing up there, I want to share with you that the seniors of this year's group, just kind of think about what's happened in the world the last couple of years. I shared with this with our touring, the church that we toured with a couple weeks ago. But the group that are seniors this year, when they were freshmen, on their tour, they went on tour, and it was the first week in March, 2020. Do you all remember what was going on the first week of March, 2020? Yeah, I do too. So these folks who were freshmen at that point in time went to go on their tour. We got the tour in. We came back on a Tuesday afternoon. We put all of our stuff back in Smith 211, and then never came back until the fall. And so this group of seniors right here, really, I kind of want to dedicate this set of Wesleyan Choir music to them, because they put up with a lot. We did a year and a half of university mandates, and then sort of a part of a semester of Dr. D's being overly cautious mandates. So these folks dealt with a lot, and we lost a few along the way, but you know what? A nice, hearty group of seniors stuck with it, and we are so incredibly proud of them. And so this whole set that we're about to do, which has a colorful theme, is really dedicated to them. So I think you're gonna really enjoy the Wesleyan Choir set here. We're gonna close out the Wesleyan Choir set with the Irish Blessing. If you are not familiar with the Irish Blessing, we do ask you can practice for the Messiah next year. The music and lyrics are in the bulletin or in the program, and we're gonna teach it to you once we do that. So the choir will sing it through once in four-part harmony. We always have a senior soloist. This year, our local star is Bree Somerville. She will sing it, and then I'll turn around and give you a cue, and then you're gonna join me in singing the Irish Blessing. That's at the very end. After which, we've got a special announcement from President Kittle, and then we'll switch it over to the instrumental portion. So please enjoy our colorful set from Wesleyan Choir.
Oh,
explain this next one. This next one is called Wood Smoke and Oranges. The students have really taken this song. It's a really cool arrangement of a Canadian kind of folk song. Not a folk song as in like Yankee Doodle, but like a song like Crosby, Stills, and Nash would do. So it's by a folk group in Canada, and then the arranger arranged into a choral setting. It's just kind of a love song to the natural world of Canada. And you're gonna hear some natural sounds of nature existing in here. There's gonna be a loon call, which there was a pair of loons by the lake this week, and it was so cool to hear them and see them, because we've been working on this piece, and to hear the sounds that you're gonna hear come forth. So when you hear those weird sounds, they're meant to be there. This is Wood Smoke and Oranges. Thank you. our souls in the waters of Lake Minnetonka. Some of you might get that.
Oh,
At this time, I would like to invite President Kittle up.
I promised Clint I wouldn't turn around and try to do any directing, so.
If only he had enthusiasm when he directed, right? Well, good afternoon. My name is Dan Kittle, and I have the privilege of serving as the president here. And this has been an afternoon I've been looking forward to for quite some time. So we have a number of recognitions that I'd like to share today. And I'd also like to start by recognizing two of our longtime supporters that have front row seats for nearly every one of these events, and for good reasons. And so, Ron and Sheila, you have been generous supporters and vital to our community at large, as well as our music community. So would you please stand so we can recognize you? Those two folks have made generous contributions that has made possible so much of what you see, both in terms of the musicians being here, the conductors, the ensemble directors, and the facilities we enjoy. So your legacy lives on here at this university. So thank you, Ron and Sheila. Ron is also a member of our Board of Trustees, and I've noticed that there are several other either former members or current members of our Board of Trustees. So if you are either a current or former member, would you please stand? Thank you to that group in terms of your leadership for the institution, and again, to my colleagues and to the students that you contribute so much to. Another special group that's actually mentioned in your program is a new group, which is called Friends of the Performing Arts. And so this is a philanthropic society that we began not long ago, and we've got great energy and enthusiasm, and many contributed to these scholarships for students. So they provide generous support to scholarships, to equipment, and to all the opportunities, including the opportunities to travel for our students. So this is a really important group. If you are a contributor to the Friends of the Performing Arts, would you please stand? Thanks to that group and to my colleagues in advancement and within the music department for establishing that. It's been a wonderful idea and I'm sure has a bright future. So what I'd like to do now is to move into a time where we announce some of the establishment of new endowed scholarships. So these scholarships were made possible through the generosity of donors who share our passion here for arts and for the commitment to nurturing these young, emerging, talented individuals. So the first one I'll announce, and unfortunately he's not able to be here tonight, but I'd still like to share a bit about the scholarship, which is for William Anderson. So we are delighted to announce the establishment of the Mary Woolsey Endowed Scholarship, generously established by William Anderson, DW Class 1972. It's in honor of his former professor and mentor. The scholarship is a testament to the impact that Mary had on the lives of her students, and it'll provide valuable support to aspiring musicians and performers for generations to come. We are deeply grateful to William for his generosity and his commitment to honoring the legacy of Mary. Through this scholarship, her influence will continue to be felt and celebrated, and we look forward to the many outstanding young artists who will benefit. So we're sorry that William cannot be here, but can we please join him in thanking him for his gift? So as many of you know in this room, the university is actively involved in both developing and now beginning to launch and implement our strategic plan. So the vision of this plan orients us towards something that's personally important to me, which is about lives of meaning and purpose, both for our colleagues as well as for our students. And that orientation of meaning and purpose is certainly alive and well in performing arts, and it's getting stronger. One of the objectives we have within our plan is to optimize the capacity of our performing arts here at Wesleyan. and one of the significant initiatives that's been funded, generously funded, by anonymous donors has been to launch what we're calling a Performing Arts Talent Coordinator. So this is an individual to be dedicated to making a significant difference in both recruiting and retaining young people and growing our performing arts here at the university. The role of talent coordinator is crucial in identifying and cultivating these gifted artists. And so I'd like to invite a familiar face, but announce him as the new Performing Arts Talent Coordinator, which is our very own Corbin Kramer. Corbin. Thank you, Corbin. I had a chance to visit with Corbin a few weeks ago, and you know he's the right person at the right time for our institution and for this position. So I'm excited for him and excited for us as well. So next, I'd like to recognize some folks who are also here in the front row. And so we are privileged to recognize special donors today, Don Schenck, class of 59, and Mary Kay Schenck, who have made a lasting impact at Dakota Wesleyan through multiple endowed gifts, including one we celebrate today. So thank you, Don and Mary Kay, for your continued support and for your generous establishment of the Schenck Bass Clef Scholarship. This scholarship is a testament to their passion for music and a commitment to fostering the talent of young singers. Their support will provide essential scholarships for male voices in the choir, ensuring that they can contribute to develop and share their remarkable gifts with the world. We are honored to have Don and Mary Kay here and as valued members of our community. Would you please stand so we can recognize you? And now for a special recognition. It is with great honor and gratitude that we recognize Jeanette Utek and her remarkable achievements as a music educator. Mrs. Utek, will you please join me up front? This one's extra special and fun because she doesn't even know why she's really here.
I got to get a clue.
Yeah, actually, would members of Mrs. Utek's family and friends please stand? There's just a wonderful group of you here today. Yes. Thank you. Thank you for being here. You know, I'm going to speak about your legacy here in a moment, but these folks are certainly your legacy as well. And I could tell from their enthusiasm that they're excited about this.
And they have all made me who I am.
So Jeanette's legacy goes back 62 years when she started teaching piano lessons as a teenager to neighborhood kids. While there's no firm record of how many students Mrs. Utek has worked with in her 62 years, it's safe to say that the number exceeds well over 400. She has now taught three generations of students from the same family. And it would surprise no one if she eventually would teach a fourth generation. Her impact goes beyond the music that she shares at the piano. The love, the care, and the wisdom that Mrs. Utek shows each of those who sit down on her bench is impactful and lifelong lasting. So, Mrs. Utek, this part is especially for you. We are proud to announce that in recognition of your outstanding contributions to music education, your family, friends, and former students have collectively contributed to the establishment of an endowed scholarship in your name. Henceforth known as the Jeanette Utek Endowed Scholarship for Performing Arts. Through your guidance and encouragement, you have instilled a love of music in so many of your students, and you have taught them not only the technical skills needed to excel in their craft, but also the value of hard work, discipline, and perseverance. Your tireless efforts have not gone unnoticed, and we are thrilled to have the opportunity to recognize your extraordinary impact on our community. The Jeanette Utek Endowed Scholarship Performing Arts will serve as a lasting tribute to your legacy and a testament to the profound impact you have had on generations of students. So at this time, I'd like to invite one of your current students, who happens to be my son, Grant, to present you with a plaque that commemorates this special moment and special day. Congratulations. So before we let her sit down, I'd like now to invite her son, Dale, to come forward, who wanted to share a few words on behalf of the family. Dale?
Thank you, President Kittle, for your idea of establishing a scholarship for my mom. Sorry, a little emotional. And Kitty Ellen, thanks for all the work you've done the last few months to make this a reality. And Mom, we're so proud. Mom would be the first to tell you that she couldn't do it without Dad, especially these last 20 years. While Mom's down in her studio from 3 to 9 on those days, Dad's making supper, doing laundry, doing some housework, so they're a great team. What else did I want to say? And Dad, thanks again, and Mom, for you working together and allowing Mom to do the things she really loves to do, is teach those great kids. So we're so proud of you. We love you. Congratulations.
My top five students are all here, of course, my children. they had a choice, especially the boys. They could practice and then play baseball and softball and football and basketball, or they could not practice and play nothing. So that worked pretty well. And there's more and more students of mine. Pam in England was my first. I took Pam and Tim. Tim's in the audience right here also. And Rhonda, I don't know where Rhonda went, over there. They were my first three that I took to the contest. And I knew not what I was doing. But from there it grew, and it just grew by, I just had wonderful kids, even up to this day. And like I say, they kind of all made me who I am. I feel very humble and very thankful. I could tell stories, and Westland made me who I am because I came here, I won't take too much more time, but I came here because I wanted to learn more about theory of piano so that kids that I taught could possibly come as a freshman year and just test out of their music appreciation class or, you know, get further right away. And so that's why I came, and that was in the days of Terry Kroll. And so we sat over in that white building you're gonna take down now. That's such a beautiful building. And we tried to figure it out, and we couldn't figure it out because I only wanted to take a couple of classes. And so then I just decided to scrap it and went back home, and I was down in my studio teaching, and the phone rang, and Terry figured it out. He said, Jeanette, we can do this. And we did. So I was here for that spring semester, the next whole year, and two summers. And then I was lucky enough to get to the middle school, where I spent 17 years. And it's just all been a wonderful trip, right from the first day of those first three students. So I'm thankful. I see current students. I see some in the back row there. I see them all over the place. And thank you all. This is a great honor.
Congratulations. And just thank everyone for being here. One of the things that I absolutely love about this university and this city is the sense of community and the sense of family. And it's never been more alive than it is here tonight. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, hello and welcome to our instrumental portion of this concert. Our first piece was the Concerto for Two Trumpets by Vivaldi, featuring one of my senior trumpet students, Kate Warren. She was amazing. And what you just saw her perform was actually her end of the year recital. But Kate, I have had so much joy as a trumpet player getting to work with Kate. She's had some really amazing instruction. I know Aaron Desmond actually started her on the trumpet, and then Molly Manchester was her band director in Eden for a long time. And so she got some amazing instruction, and I just had the blessing of getting to work with her in her final years here. But she said, "Hey, Bethany, would you like to do a duet?" And I said, "Well, there's this piece I've always wanted to do. I've never had a student that could do it." And so we finally got to do it. So thank you for helping me get to perform one of my bucket list pieces. And let's give another hand to Kate. Our next set features several solos. And these are all big band pieces that feature strings. The really amazing thing about the next three pieces that you're gonna hear is that the music that the orchestra is playing is the original music from the original studio recordings. So we're going to have Grace up first, and she is going to be singing "Come Rain or Come Shine" as recorded by Peggy Lee.
Thank you.
now like to welcome up Ryan Staley to conduct our next piece.
And just because she stole the mic, I think hopefully you all hear me, but in addition to be playing wonderful trumpet, little did you know she is a wonderful vocalist. Would you help me welcome to the stage to sing our next tune, Fascinating Rhythm, Dr. Bethany Amundson.
Just because he made me do that. Now we're featuring Ryan Staley on this next one. So this is off the Charlie Parker with Strings album. This is Ryan Staley on What Is This Thing Called Love? So the students and I just decided that with this final concert of the year, we just wanted to have a great time. And they have been asking for something that they've been calling a nostalgia theme for quite some time. So this is all kind of music that's like blasts from the past and things that are fond memories from their childhood. We even have a throwback to our seniors' freshman year when we did Mamma Mia here. But they made the suggestions for all the pieces on the band part of the program. They suggested all of them. They chose the music, and this is a concert for them. So I hope you enjoy our nostalgia set. Next is going to be something, they are all little Disney babies at heart, and so they wanted to play a Disney medley, and we selected music from Aladdin.
Thank you.
heard Regan Pilker on the saxophone. She did an amazing job on that solo. And also Kate Warren on the trumpet solo. And for the last piece of the band portion of the concert, make sure you stay for the jazz band because they're amazing. But for the last piece, we wanted to bring up student conductor Corey Dowling. Corey has owned the entire rehearsal process of the piece. She's been with them from the first sight read now to the final concert. So please welcome Corey.
Thank you. Check one, two. That first tune that we did for you was a tune called Prime Suspect. It featured Connor up here on tenor saxophone and also Bethany Amundsen back on trumpet. Give it a round of applause for our soloists. Our next tune, if you were here at the concert in March, this is one that the students wanted to bring back just because it's got a funny title, but it's a lot of fun to play. This is Crunchy Frog, and it's going to feature a number of solos. So hope you enjoy. This is Crunchy Frog.
Ha ha ha! Okay, in a day that has been filled with wonderful music, wonderful celebrations of generosity and hard work and dedication, I hope you'll sit and bear with me for one more very important honor. Many of you might not know that in December, Dr. Bethany Amundson was named the Director of Bands at the University of South Dakota. And so it is with great sadness that this is our last concert with Dr. Amundson. We are so privileged and proud to be part of her musical journey. When she was hired back in 2015, she had one job, and it was to create and develop the student instrumental experience here at Dakota Wesleyan. I think today, especially in the second half of the program, you see that Dr. Amundson has definitely done that, and then some. Would you please join me in giving Dr. Amundson a well-deserved round of applause? So there are a number of students here that want to pay a short tribute, as well as her colleagues from the jazz band and from Lyricwood. I just want to give her, this was very hard to do this in secret because she's always around the music area. So all of the students at in the Wesleyan band, in Lyricwood, all the community members of Lyricwood, members of jazz band, anybody who's a student who took part under the baton of Dr. Amundson today, signed this. This is a poster from today's concert, enlarged, framed, and we figured you'd display this in your office so that you won't forget your friends here at Wesleyan.
So I would like to, on behalf of the band, I'd really just like to thank Dr. Amundson for everything that she's done. She's allowed us to grow as people and musicians, and we have a framed photo of our band family from the tour that we went on. I think that's Alexandria, yes. Hanson, sure. we wanted to choose this photo because it is your band family, and we just want to remind you that we will always be your family no matter what.
Nobody told her she was going to have to direct an orchestra. But we had some really terrific times. While Bethany got her legs under her and her baton under her, learning how to direct an orchestra, which is not the same as directing a band, from Lyricwood. Hold that. More appropriate than a little kid cardboard violin with notes.
You know, I knew that this day would come, and I'm sitting here thinking, you know, should I write something down? Should I be prepared? And I should have been, so I'm going to wing most of this, but most of you probably don't know that Bethany has been, like, actively involved in our high school instrumental department. She came on a number of years ago, just kind of wanted to help with the marching band. She's worked with a number of my students. They think of her as kind of the band mom. Most of the time, if, you know, they need something, they hurt, you know, like maybe they scraped a knee, they don't go to me, they just go to Bethany. She has been absolutely amazing to work with. And part of the reason why I joined on here this year to work with the jazz band. The success that we've seen here this year, which has been great, has been everything to do with what she started the first year. And her her presence and the hold that she's going to leave in this community is pretty great. But we have absolutely loved having her be a part of it. We're scheming ways to get down to Vermilion to hang out and take our band down there to any event that's happening. I just can't say enough great things about her. Would you give her one more round of applause, Dr. Bethany Ammons?
Y'all are a bunch of stinkers for making me cry. This place has been amazing. It's been a home away from home. I found friends that have become family here. I can't believe that in 2015 we started and we had 6 students on that little stage back there. 6 students, and look how far we've come. And I know under the leadership of Dr. D and the rest of the music department that it's only gonna keep growing, and I will continue to be your biggest fan. So thank you for all the blessings.
Now get back to work, Bethany. Let's go. You got one more song. One of the great things about jazz band, without boring you with the history of this music, is it's very much rooted in improvisation. Improvisation is where these students and adults are standing up and playing music that is just kind of created on the fly. It's a very, very big part of the history of this music. And so on this last tune, we have a number of soloists. It's a very, very funky tune by Delbert McClinton called Shaky Ground. And it's going to feature a number of solos. So if you're soloing on this chart, can you raise your hand? There we go. Okay, so too many to even mention. So we're going to do one more chart. Thank you so much for attending this afternoon. We hope you have enjoyed what you've heard. This is Shaky Ground. Thank you.